Did you screw up the previous month's reconciliation and now you have to find a way to fix it? Well, don't worry, because in this video, we're going to show how to undo a bank reconciliation in QuickBooks Online. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. Undoing a bank reconciliation happens because everybody screws up a bank rec sometimes. You must undo the reconciliation and redo the bank reconciliation correctly if you want your records to be correct. Only the accountant user can undo a reconciliation. So you must either be logged in as the accountant's user or use the accountant's edition of the QuickBooks Online software. And for many of you following this course, when you signed up for the accountant's edition, so you will be able to undo. So what happens when you undo a reconciliation? Well, only two things will change. First, the last reconciled on date will be moved back to the previous month. And the only other thing that happens is anything that was marked cleared in the previous reconciliation is now uncleared, and you have to start again fresh and click and check all of the ones in the previous month's reconciliation to get it to be correct. Please note, however, QuickBooks Online will undo the adjustment you made during the last reconciliation. So if you take a look at the reports right now and you go to the trial balance and you open up cash in bank, when you scroll to the very bottom, the last one that you will see is this ADJ, this adjustment that we made, and we told QuickBooks make it on May 31, and you can see it lowered the balance in order to force it to fit the wrong number. This is going to disappear when we undo the reconciliation. So we click the cog wheel and click reconcile. And of course we have the correct account, but in order to undo the most recent reconciliation, you have to click history by account. Now, this window is very interesting. It organizes all of your previous bank reconciliations by year. We have only done bank reconciliations for this company in 2017. But if we did additional ones in 2018, they would be listed here. And 2019 reconciliations will be listed here and so on. You have to click the triangle to get the pull-down list of every reconciliation that we did in that year, 2017. These are all the bank recs we did in the prior videos. Notice this is the statement ending date, and notice this is the date that they were physically performed. And of course, I'm recording this video series in January of 2020. So this is the actual date that it happened, and this is the statement date that you're reconciling. You may also notice that the last one that we're working on was the one that we did in the previous video. And it actually lists the amount of adjustment for you to see. You can click the pull down arrow and then you can click undo for the specific month that you want to undo. Now when you do that, you get this warning message asking you if you're sure you want to undo this reconciliation, and it tells you how many transactions were in the reconciliation. It also reminds you of everything that it will do at the moment that you click yes for undoing. We will click yes, and it says, we'll undo this, okay, click undo. Now it has successfully undid the last reconciliation. And when we click OK, we can check that the adjustment that we made in the last video has been removed. We click Reports, Trial Balance, Cash in Bank. And now when we scroll to the very, very bottom of Cash in Bank, you see the last entry is on May 27th and the adjustment is gone. Now we can actually reconcile it properly. Now here we are in the previous bank statement with everything marked off because the transactions were correct, just the ending balance that we put was wrong. So let's clear that out so that we're starting fresh and we can mark them one by one as we do the reconciliation properly. Click here and again click Reconcile, and this time be very careful to record the proper ending balance into the window. And that was the mistake we made last time, but we did not make a mistake with the ending date. Okay, and we come down to start reconciling, and here we go. We're going to do exactly what we did in the previous video. UPS minus 400, that's correct. So we mark it in blue. The 1200 from Alan is correct. So we come back to the statement and we mark it in blue. I'm going quickly because most students watching have already done this a few times. $35 to Chase Bank for the fee is there. Let's mark it in blue. Oops, I'm going a little fast. Okay. The $26.60 to Betty, that's also there. So let's mark it in blue. The $5.94 is also in both places the same. So we come back and mark it in blue. $19.20.80 is there. So we check it in QuickBooks and mark it in blue in the statement. Is the $16.65 there? Yes, it is. So we check it in the QuickBooks Online and mark it off in the statement. $900 is there. So we check it in QuickBooks Online and we mark it off in the statement. The $300 to Risa is in QuickBooks Online. Let's just scroll down. So if it's the same in QuickBooks Online, we mark it in blue in the statement. Now look closely. There's a $500 difference. Look closely. We mark off this $1,000 here. We mark it off. And if it's the same in the statement, which it is, we mark it in blue. Now watch. The very last one on the statement is $500. At the moment, the difference is $500. At the moment we mark in QuickBooks Online, the very last one in the statement, that's the moment the difference becomes zero. So we mark it off in the bank statement to show that all of these have been entered exactly as shown into QuickBooks Online. And if you remember, we leave these last two alone. We do not click them because they are not on May's bank statement. They should probably appear in June or on June's bank statement. So we have a difference of zero and we click Finish Now, and then we click Done. Congratulations. We've covered every possible topic and feature regarding bank reconciliation in QuickBooks Online.